welcome to break. For those who didn't see the first episode of this, what this is about is making those things we use to postpone. Most of us have something that we want to do one day when we get time. So I decided to take 1 hour each day to make some of these things that one tends not to get done. So, and the first part is restoring this ship. I'll take the mouse here. This is a frigate, the Jutland. I built many years ago, 35 years ago or something like that. And then we have moved around and so on, and it had ended up on attics and down in cellars and where not. If I ever would save it, it was about time to do it now, because or else it would not be able to do that. So you can see the things are broken, and yesterday we was cleaning, and we had some more cleaning to do before we get it nice. So that will keep on, so we make it as nice as when it was brand new like this. It was just finished when I took it outside the house, so I shot it but it don't look like that anymore. You can see, in here, it's dusty and dirty and everything bad with it. So, but now we will try to clean it up, and a lot of stuff is missing and some is broken and so on, but we will fix it and make it look like when it was born again. So I think it's a little hard to see over here from the here in the back, and still very nasty stuff. So we will keep on doing it until it's 1 hour a day and see how far we get with that amount of time. But I'm making a lot of other stuff, so I can only take an hour. But an hour is better than nothing. Maybe we can lift some of the stuff up here. No, we cannot. Yeah. And I have taken a water solution with just a little of soap in it, and then I'll try to clean it up in that way, because I'm afraid it is tempting to just take it out in the shower and then drench it all, but I'm afraid that will have some dire consequences. but even the little you did yesterday have helped a lot. But there's a long way before we get it to look like we want. The first thing must be to clean it. And it was tempting to just take and cut all the lines, but and rig it from start, but it takes hundreds and hundreds of hours to rig it, because all of these are not just glued on, they are bent, every single one of them. Or not bent. What's the name? Tied. Every one of them with a knot. So it's not that easy. That's one would think. And it's done exactly like they would have done it when they built the ship. But I'm afraid if I started to put it in the shower, it will warp, and then it's over with. Because it's not painted on the inside, it's only on the outside, so I'm afraid it will go real wrong with it if we did that. A lot of spiders have had a good home here, because there is spider web all over the place. If I don't do it now, it will be far gone. Too far gone to make it again. we did yesterday have helped a lot. And don't look that miserable. I had a mantra around it at one time, but it was kind of a big monstrosity to move around with, so I gave up that part, which I shouldn't have done. Kept it in there, it would have been as new, but I didn't. Somebody have a fun time down on the street. See, it's kind of dirty all over the place. See on the cannons, it's been a while since they have been fired. see anything anyway. Some of the cannons are tilted. These cannons were on wheels, and there are a rope around them behind their back, so they don't run over the guy who fired them. Or ended up on the other side of the deck. Really powerful, but they are not that precise. They were lucky if they hit something with them. Nasty stuff. Turn around a little so I can see it. Camera. See if that helps. This one is in the way. That was not much better, but better than nothing. Because some of these are kind of tilted. stand like they should. What is this hanging in? Sometimes it's difficult to see. Put it up here. Then I have room. Yeah. Because I need to get over in the corner. Wash your stairs. Oops. This one off. Glue that on again. Then we'll break this off too. Then we can better get it. And I have spares of all of it, so I can fix it. have a deck boy to fix one. Helps all the times. unbelievable how dirty it can get. Dust standing around. This up, and it's easier to. Maybe we can take the other one up too. No, not yet, because I didn't use water resistant glue, because it was never intended to get out and sail. So if you want to get one of these in water, you need to have a lot of ballast in the horn, and there is nothing in this one. In the real ship, there is a lot of stone down there in the keel. Big heavy stone. This one will just topple over because it will kind of stand on the water. But you could put stuff in it and sail with it. But this one is right now is leaking. Of course, there is a lot of cracks in it. But we will fix that. Change the picture or to this one, because we will try to get that this in here. Maybe I should do it from the other side. Move the mouse. And you can see how dusty it is on the side. How is it with this? Oh. See the, all the cannons in the ports here, the cannon ports are down in the hold. So, and you see the cracks along the side. Okay, yes, I have to be sure. one of the problems too is that I smoke, so that does make that. Dust kind of what should we call it? Sticky. You see this yellow stuff here. That's the result of many packets of cigarettes. Many. Not car wash, it's boat wash. Here in the city where I live, Svendborg, Denmark, we have a lot of these big tall ships. They're really nice in the summer. See them all if you like that type of cup. I have taken a lot of pictures of them. I kind of love those. A lot of ship interested people on this part. A lot of wooden ship started from here and took the trip out in the world. A the world's biggest, what do we call it? Maskline is from started here in Svendborg, and it's only a little town on, I guess we are around 40,000 people in Svendborg, so it's compared to the big cities around the world, Svendborg is small. Container ships, or a lot of them around the world. Maersk Line. There are others too. The biggest one of them all is. It's from here. Navigation shoes and that kind of things. But I'm mostly to the old ones. But you need a lot of money to run these old ships, because they are on the yard all the time. All the winter months they are down here in the yards with blankets over them. A lot of Russians, millionaires and so on, have a lot of these ships because it's so crazy expensive to keep them running. We need a lot of money. And it don't have any ending to it, the money spending on them. They have to be fixed all the time. Every year they have to. And something broken off here. Some of the wires we need to go, and some of the lines we need to cut. Those here, so we can get a new piece of that on. But we'll see. When it's cleaned up, how drastic we need to go at it, how much we have to cut. And you can see this one is kind of loose too. I guess we can put that in place again if we can. This one is still around also, the in the town of Abeltoft. It lays in the harbor. It's like brand new, beautiful ships. Ship. Restored from all the way to took many years. But I'm glad they did. I've seen it many times. I think we are down there each summer and with the grandkids and so on. The last battle it participated in was in 1864, the Battle of Helgoland. It was kind of already when it they built it, it was kind of out of their time. This was a steam and sail vessel. We are putting a chimney on there later. See the propeller, even if it's kind of broken. But then they found more modern stuff. And then they made the big battleships, and they are kind of forwarded to those big ones they used in Second World War. Those they don't build anymore. But maybe we get back to sail ships once again when there have been experiments. Making, not like this one, but to save fuel and computer driven sail ships. not as pretty as these are. And we can enjoy the models of them. And there are many models out there you can buy in there and build yourself. If you have the time and the patience, you need a lot of patience. Determination. But it is what to do. Problem. It's hard for me to remember years back how I did it. At least some of it. But it looks better for me every day. At least it's not that nasty to look at. A little still, but not that. That's when we started. But this what work we got done today. Well, you can see me. We need to and this is twisted around like crazy, so it must be, I don't know. We will pick it out and you can follow along, and I hope we'll see you again tomorrow, and you can follow me on YouTube, Pixel Fantasy Live, and you can follow on my site, pixelfantasies.com, and where we make stop motion movie and make something for kids and this one. And in the future there will be a lot more, but one step at a time. So I will say bye bye, and because I have to prepare for the next show that is in a half an hour. So until then, we will go to replay. So in the meanwhile, I will replay. So bye.